from T.S. Eliot's poem, The Wasteland. April is the cruelest month, breathing lilacs out of the dead land, mixing memory and desire, stirring dull roots with spring rain. April has special resonance for Armenians everywhere. It was on April 24, 1915, that the Turkish government launched a premeditated, organized campaign to eliminate the millennia-old Armenian people from their historical lands in what is now southeastern Turkey. As many as 1.5 million Armenians perished in the 20th century's first genocide. Survivors were scattered all over the Middle East and the rest of the world. The Turkish officials responsible for the genocide were never brought to account. This was not lost on Adolf Hitler. He saw that a minority could be wiped out with impunity. Just days before launching World War II, Hitler told his generals, "Who today, after all, speaks of the annihilation of the Armenians?" What makes the 20th century's first Holocaust unique is that Turkey, despite mountains of documentary evidence, refuses to acknowledge it ever happened. And that denial is the final stage of genocide. Closure and justice is denied to the victims and their descendants. In Turkey today, to speak of the genocide is a crime. Orhan Pamuk, celebrated author of Snow and Turkey's Nobel Prize winner for literature, was prosecuted for mentioning it. Pamuk, under death threats, has left Turkey. Others who have spoken out, such as historian Taner Akcam and novelist Elif Shafak, have also been threatened. Journalist Hrant Dink was not so lucky. He was murdered on January 16, 2007, right in front of his newspaper office on one of Istanbul's most prominent boulevards. Dink, too, dared to utter the unutterable. Dink's murder and funeral brought large crowds of Turks and Armenians onto the streets of Istanbul in solidarity. Many signs said, "We are all Armenians." Elsewhere, in another demonstration, a woman held up a sign that said, 1.5 million plus one.